All right, we are back with another virtual interview, and I have with me Jeremy. Jeremy, thanks for joining us.
Thanks for inviting me.
Yes, you came a long way to be here.
Yes, from Germany.
Yes, and for the folks out there that haven't had a chance to meet you, why don't you tell them a little bit about your company and what they do and what you do?
So we are ReTest, and what we do is the intention is to bring AI into testing, and it turns out that this is difficult because the AI doesn't know whether, for instance, the button should be red or green. So it can't find the problem if the button is red but should be green. Mm-hmm. So what we do instead is we just record what happens in one instance. And then if you create a new version of the software, then we see where the differences are.
Right.
And then we show you as a human the differences, and you can decide whether this is what you want or not.
Yeah.
And it turns out that this functionality of recording the differences even works well without AI and even solves a lot of problems. And this is what we right now we produce as open source. So you can use the tool ReCheck for web, for instance, as an open source tool and create different versions. So see where the website changes.
Wow.
Even cross-browser, cross-device, or through versions.
Yeah. Now, you guys have had some recent developments, too, as a company, right? So some growth and some good things happening just in terms of that. So maybe talk a little bit about that for folks, too. I mean, being someone who, you know, started up an organization and, you know, had this idea, you know, to do this that would bring this to the world. A little bit about that, maybe, because I know there's probably some folks out there saying, like, we talked to Wilson earlier. He said you guys are building the cleaning robot.
Yes.
So for those folks out there that aspire to be entrepreneurs like you guys and like Jason we just talked to, maybe some thoughts on how you went about that and started that process.
So I started by myself initially, and it it was kind of a spin-off from the PhD thesis. And then we had a lot of pivots because initially we wanted to do AI testing. And then we got customer feedback and they said, this doesn't work well. So we changed the approach. And then they said, okay, better, but it still doesn't work well. So we changed the approach. And we got a lot of feedback loops and had to pivot and adjust a lot. And but it helped us tremendously to create a very good overall approach. Like what we have now, the recheck tool that does the checking, that's purely from customer input. That we wouldn't have had that without customers.
Yeah,
and
that's amazing.
Yeah, and it's helped us. So now we have an investor. We are now 15 people, and constantly growing, looking for new hires. By the way,
see, there you go. Someone's looking. Yeah, right. Exactly. Where do they have to be based to be for you? Where are
so
you guys?
So Eile, we are German based. So Eile, we are looking right now for people in the vicinity. Of Karlsruhe, the bigger Karlsruhe area. Future plans are to expand. To different locations. But we'll see about that. That's not yet.
Yeah, not yet. But tune in and find you guys if you guys are looking for an opportunity in this space. You have customers using your tool.
Yes.
And so maybe there are people using this that are having a lot of success. Like you said, you got a lot of customer input and feedback. You know, maybe give some of the use cases of what you guys are working with right now and how that's helped them. Just so people out there that are probably saying, oh, I may need this. You know, what's a good use case to say it's a good tool for me and it'll work well?
So for the ReCheck tool, which does the difference analysis, we have a big customer, which is the German Ministry of Schooling, and they have a software that contains all the data about pupils and teachers and grades and everything. And because of German GDPR regulations, they are not allowed to have this centralized. So they want to test that. So they, what they want to do is before upgrading the software, they want to test it in the wild. But they can't get the data. So what they do is they create tests that work without data. So they, without knowing the data, so you have an abstract test case, and then you load it into a specific school. You create the initial version, and then you upgrade the system, and then you run the test again and see what changed.
Right.
So you can create abstract tests that are separate from the test data.
Yeah.
And this is a, I think
great
this is a
use
cool,
case. Yeah.
cool use case.
Yeah, it will, absolutely. And we were just talking about that. That's a challenge for a lot of people, right? Around, you know, just test data and how do you, how are you able to optimize and scale on some of the things you need to do, mm-hmm. right? So for folks out there that are looking for solutions to that, mm-hmm. Do they just find you on the website then? Is it?
Yes.
Yeah?
So we okay. have retest.dev and retest.org and retest.de. Okay. So essentially you enter retest into web and you
find us. And they'll
find
you.
Yes.
And they'll find the organization. So what are you seeing kind of now? I was just talking to Jason about it too. You two have been in the AI space mm-hmm. longer, right? There mm-hmm. didn't used to be a lot of people talking mm-hmm. about, but obviously here now we have a panel later this mm-hmm. week with more people that are talking about it. Anything you're seeing in terms of trends around it or fears? Because initially it's always fear with something new, mm-hmm. Usually with people or things that educationally you want people to know about AI in the space.
So I think a lot of companies are using AI not as a technical term, but as a marketing term. So mm-hmm. they are very, there's a lot of wiggle room what counts as AI as an, and not.
Right.
And but I personally think that's not a problem if the tool works. So if you've got a working tool, it doesn't matter if it's AI or not.
Right.
But right. You should scrutinize that. So
yeah, absolutely. Jason and I were just talking about that too, because that's the hard part, I think, right now with a group of people this week that I've been talking to is I think sometimes with new technology, people who sell things, not your organization or company, but vendors in general sometimes, the fear is that they are doing marketing things, mm-hmm. right? And they're relying on the fact that the person and consumer buying it isn't educated enough mm-hmm. to have the information to tell, mm-hmm. you know, what is good and what isn't good mm-hmm. and what works and doesn't work. So I think your point of, you know, people have to, you know, do some homework and research to mm-hmm. validate what works for them. And mm-hmm. if it works, that's great, but know if it's truly AI mm-hmm. that you're using or if it's just something else, right? Mm-hmm. And that's fine, but know that and kind of do your mm-hmm. homework and research on it. So where are good places if people just want to get a little more educated around AI that they could go to?
So places for learning about AI, that's a good question though. I think Udacity has some courses on that. Mm-hmm. And Angie Jones is creating a couple of tutorials about
yeah.
A lot of aspects of AI.
Right.
And other than that, I guess reading articles and stuff.
Yeah.
But I haven't tried myself because I haven't researched the fundamentals of that from the web, so I'm not sure about that part.
Yeah. But yeah, that's something too, I think, just finding sources, right?
Yeah, right.
So there's going to be different sources out there and just getting information, you know,
yes.
to learn about the things you want to learn about. You have access to a lot of the folks that have information.
Coming to conference is a good idea.
Yeah, coming to the conference is a good idea. You'll get access to all of them all in one place that have ideas on it. Any other trends you're kind of seeing with consumers? Like you guys are obviously have customers that are using your product and want to sell more of that product. Are you seeing people being more open to it or getting the value of using it?
So yeah, what we recognize is that many people find us because of AI, and
yeah.
then what they end up using is not AI
right.
focused. So, for instance, that checking mechanism
yeah.
has nothing to do with AI,
right.
but it's our main selling proposition right now. That's what people
yeah.
Use a lot in practice because it's
right.
it offers so many benefits,
right.
and it works without AI. But
right.
AI is the reason that people come to us and find us.
Yeah, that's so interesting, right? Like people want to know about that piece, mm-hmm. but what actually fits for them may be something different.
Mm-hmm.
So it's all about, I think I look at it as other tools we have available to us, mm-hmm. right? So you look at what's the right thing to do for mm-hmm. the situation and the use case that you have, and you use it as something that's available to you.
Mm-hmm. Right.
So, perfect. So again, just one last time so they know, the website to find you guys if you want more information on your product.
So you can find us at retest.de or retest.dev or retest.org, on LinkedIn, on Twitter, retest.en. You can contact us anytime. And the chat on the website will always be answered. So we're happy to serve.
Wonderful. Thanks, everyone. Stay tuned. We'll have more interviews later today.
Thank you.